brought together a session full of inspirational women who will be empowering us, talking to us about work-life balance and how we can achieve all of this and still be the best version of ourselves. It is no secret that being a professional working mother and a partner or wife is hard.
We are not going to be successful, and I really would like to emphasize this, especially to young people. If we don't burn our fingers trying to find solutions for the good, if we believe that we are incapable because someone else who actually knows zilch, if I may be brave enough to use that word, about the business, comes with a suitcase full of solutions to you. Perhaps a middle road is what you may want to think of. Is try, burn your fingers, fall, stand up and dust your backside, and then say, can I maybe test what I'm doing with something? Not sit back and have a co-manager or a co-CEO running your business for you. Developing mastery comes from roughing it up.
You have given us a challenge to say we must affirm ourselves as women, affirm our power and our capability and our leadership. And I would say with confidence today, because of the foundation that you laid for us, without even knowing some of us, and without even seeing it as little as I was at that time, but through the years, and as we still continue to monitor the impact you've made in different industries, and we look back and we say it's because of women like you that we stand strong today and we're striving to grow up and just be like you.
But what's important is that if you have females in your workforce who don't have a sense of control of their life, so you're feeling overwhelmed and everything seems to be like a rush and so on, you can never be good to an organization. And probably it should be in the interest of the organizations and in the interest of all of us to make sure that you get to a point where you are comfortable in your skin with all of these things that you need to do. By the way, I don't believe in juggling either, because I've watched jugglers at a circus, sometimes one of the tokens fall. So that can't be perfect either. So as we consciously strive towards getting a balance, we need to understand that there's no perfect one size fits all. We're all individuals, we've got different challenges, so you have to make sure that you customize it for yourself.
Being consistent in how you present yourself to people. Because it's easy to try out one thing one day and then the next time be something else. You can't be on time today and the next time you're not, or you're prepared today and the next time you're not. You send in confusing messages to people. And the human mind is so lazy that the easiest thing, if you can't make sense of something, you just switch off from it. When people can't understand you or they can't place you somewhere, they write you off. They forget about you. I don't know if that's happened to anyone of you. Where the relationship was coming along fine, but you kept postponing and cancelling the meetings. And then one day they just stopped trying to shake you the supplement. Right? Because that's just how it works. So the importance of being consistent. The person that you are, which is your core image, has to be reflected in all these other elements. The decisions that you make influence how people expect or imagine you to be.
So we've had the SAIEE Women's Day today, and we're actually quite proud that we had a lot of engineers that came, as well as students, and we had a few distinguished guests like Dolly, who's a very successful lady in the industry. We've had Sis Elsie, and we've had an image consultant as well, which is Doris. And I think the people that have come have definitely benefited from it, and we would like to obviously expand on it going into the future and have more maybe training sessions and interactive sessions, panel discussions perhaps. So this is just a start, a teaser of what we've had so far, but we look forward to actually having a more meaningful session and where we can enrich, especially the students and younger generation, but in particular, women. Ikamalama kosi kasi mali bongwe, mali
Mali bongwe, ipitso la mafuma hadi.